I am Menard Casey, running for mayor of Vancouver, November 19th, Saturday, Vancouver Civic Election. What I'll do is, first of all, I'd reduce property taxes by 1%, just to offset the HST. And for businesses that aren't small businesses, I'd actually increase their business taxes. They got a bit of a break on the HST, but I think it was such a bungled mess to begin with. I mean, the province, I mean, Clark and Falcon, they both land and they try to cover up a lie. Gordon Campbell lost his job. This is part of why I'm running. With $30 million of our tax dollars, I manage a movie company for 12 years, and I'm sick of the federal government taking 50% of our check, using the money through a federal statute, through the provinces, and my point is federal taxes and provincial taxes, HST, anything after the PST should be separate. Like the fact that they were able to even partly get away with, without, thanks to Bill Vanderzam, tax at least 10, 12, 15 items through the province and to rent, strata fees, cars, computers, cameras. It was just the most ridiculous thing from start to finish. $27 million from the city's annual operating budget for 400 new constables to reduce gang crime. I'm a delegate for the Vancouver Police Board. I'm a certified criminologist from Native Education Center, which means I do hold a certificate in criminology. I think gangs like the Hells Angels are taking over our streets. They control the drug trade. They're telling our kids what to do. I mean, I wouldn't dare question my boss about wages for certain items, but I do agree with, I would keep the salaries of police officers, our boys and girls in blue, the same, but I would use the annual operating budget to get 400 more officers. Proactive patrol has a dramatic effect in reducing gang crime. When you see cops walking around, it just makes people feel safer. It garners investment and people go shopping in the middle of the night in downtown Vancouver. The Occupy Vancouver, I supported it for a while, but honestly, there's sort of a catch-22. Someone OD's on drugs in it while people are shopping downtown, and I was at the debate with Gregor and Suzanne, and I didn't even get a question in edgewise. Every 15 seconds, they were just going overboard trying to get their message across, but they lost their message because someone overdosed. They couldn't even admit it. I think it's time for them to pick up the tents and go. And what I'd do, my first move for mayor, I'd use my existing powers to get rid of them. I mean, it's what I would have done. This is Gregor's mistake and the police chief Chu's mistake, not only with the riot, for the Occupy Vancouver. What they should never have let people set up tents in the first place. They knew Christmas season was coming. There's over 575,000 taxpayers in Vancouver. Don't get me wrong, they got a constitutional right to be there, but if you talk to these people, not a lot of these, it's not like they're actually homeless people from Vancouver. I mean, the girl that OD'd is from Victoria. So I got a bit of a major problem with that. I only knew one guy that was actually from Vancouver, but regardless, it's a message and it's Occupy and it's going worldwide, so they kind of use that as a theme. But I mean, it's time to turn the page on the Occupy thing. It's time for them to go home. They can protest, but they lost their message and they should have just admitted it. Once someone OD'd, it's time to pack up the tents and go. I mean, you're affecting business. The DVBIA, the Charles Goth, he's got a bit of a point. I mean, it's when you're affecting incoming taxes. The thing is, with the city, more than 60 meters squared of tent space is actually, which they've kept it just under, I think, is actually requires a permit. So it's not like they're paying for it. So the policing costs and everything combined, we're close to $1.5 million, I think. So yeah, it's just too much. I think it's time for him to go home. And my other thing for mayor thing, whatever, that's okay. Okay. I reverse the raises Gregor envisioned. Gave themselves a 25% raise before the HST. Reason being is obvious. They saw the HST coming, and they still gave themselves raises. And my main problem with politicians, I mean, it's they just keep lying with our tax dollars, and then they get away with it to do it again and again. And it's just, there's got to be a matter. What I would to do, my first move for mayor, absolutely, once I win the Vancouver mayor's seat, I would create, legislate locally through the Vancouver Charter. My first motion would be create at all levels. I want to run against Hedy Fry in Vancouver Centre. So what I would do locally first is create a mandatory polling for politicians at every level, the Premier, the Prime Minister, and whoever's sitting in the mayor's chair in Vancouver. And it would be like you go in the province and it's just got instant real-time connected comments, but people would be counting, and if any sort of weird comments or just fizzlers would just be shoved off to the side, sort of thing. But you could actually get real-time quotes, and it is, politicians just keep lying to us with their own money. I got a major problem with that. Like, it's how you, when you're running against millionaires and people, they get money from developers to make rules for developers. And don't get me wrong, I don't think there's any corruption in Vancouver, but I do believe that we need to, the province, since Gordon Kendall Bell got fired, that he got fined and he was tried, and since Gordon Campbell and Kendall Bell, no one's even, the province, Christy Clark, she's not only not finding shelters, she can't control BC Hydro's pay executives, and things like that. Like, what are they even doing? They can't even control the costs and spending by all politicians. It's just, it's got to stop. They're lying to us with our own money. And I can't afford to run because they control the corporations. We need Falcon to reduce the corporate tax rate instead of, or increase the corporate tax rate instead of reduce it by 2 points. We need Jim Flaherty to increase the corporate tax rate from, I think he dropped it from 12 to 10%. We need him to increase it to at least 14, 15. And I think the federal government, my first move as a member of parliament, hopefully in the next federal election, would be to freeze EI premiums at 40%. Easily the federal government can survive on that. Since the pension scandals of, does anybody remember Jane Stewart? It's like a $45 billion. We'll be paying for the overrun social programs of the Liberals, provincially and federally, for the last 20 years. You see, don't get me wrong, I want housing for moms and dads, single edge. Like, I'm trying to represent the working poor here, the homeless, and I would truly get homes for the homeless. But my problem with that whole scenario is there's an entire group, millions of seniors that will be retiring in the next 5-10 years. And if they're not working, you see, this is when the liberal social programs were actually flourishing, and it was they were able to provide taxation through that sort of initiative, because these seniors, that's when they were working. Now they're not, there's nothing incoming. They still got houses, but they're not able to sustain them because they're not working. Now, how are we going to be able to provide housing and long-term care beds for people that aren't even working? It sounds bad, but it's true. Like, what about the entire next generation? You know, I mean, the province is too worried about non-accredited programs at UBC and SFU. I mean, we got people that are running in student elections, and they won't lower tuition because they're too worried about more money from other parts of the world. I mean, globalization is one thing, but when we got kids that have talent that can't afford to go to school, their only option is scholarships, which are too far and far between. Anyways, this has been pretty long, but vote for Menard Casey on November 19th, because I'd make the best mayor in history. Thank you.